What is going on, guys? Welcome back to another Pocophone F1 video. And in today's video, I'm going to show you how you can completely turn your Pocophone F1 into a OnePlus 6. Yes, finally, I'm showing you guys a stable version of the Voxion OS for our Pocophone F1, the Beryllium. And yeah, I did take my time. The last time that I made a video on this was almost 2 to 3 months ago. That was actually the Voxion OS Beta Pi. But now we have finally booted a stable version of it and almost everything completely works over here, which is just amazing. Next to this stability would be the Redmi Note 5 Pro. No other phone with Voxion OS runs this stable. Like, this is completely daily driver usable. So again, if you're tired of MIUI or custom ROMs, this is the way you can go, like completely. Well, let's just take a look at this. This now runs on, again, the stock Pi vendor, which is just amazing. You don't need any kind of patch kernel or vendor for it from a custom ROM like Cyberia OS or Moki. This runs off the stock vendor, which again makes much more stabler. For example, if you are using the latest Pi Beta, you have the newest touch drivers with it. So again, the typing and all the PUBG mistakes are completely gone over here. And then let's just take a look. So this is Voxion OS, the latest from the OnePlus 6. OnePlus 6T is also available, but the fingerprint scanner doesn't work on that build. OnePlus 6 just works fine, as you can see. Tap. There you go, extremely quick. But on the left, as you can see, you have your normal shelf, you have your normal widgets over here, nothing new in that. Then again, you have quick settings panel with your notifications in it, pretty cool. You have normal amount of toggles over here, such as gaming mode, location, everything just works fine, no issues at all. Then again, these are your folders, pretty great. Let's just swipe up. So this is your menu. Again, not a lot of bloat over here. The ROM is pretty de-bloated and only the utility stuff has been just retained over here. So for example, you have calculator, camera, Chrome, clock, and all the UI is again pretty much updated to the latest of it. So for example, again, the UI is much more bigger and easier on the eyes. Also, you can see there is screen bleeding still happening on my Poco. This is one of the first Pocos I bought it into the first sale, but yeah, I do have kind of like the screen bleeding, as you guys asked. So again, those who bought it later, lucky you. Then going through the other apps, you have contacts. But the performance of this ROM is just on par. I actually feel this is faster than my OnePlus 6. Like, it's just mind-blowing how fast this ROM is. Even if you open heavy apps like File Manager, it just opens in no time. Again, it's as productive as MIUI. For example, you have all your images, APKs and downloaded files in one tab. You have Lockbox, File Manager, then again you have large files and stuff. Pretty great, to be honest. Then you have Gallery, which is now completely white. Not a huge fan of it, but you still get it. Again, the picture quality is pretty great from the OnePlus camera. Then you have messages, notes. Notes again looks like a bit of a MIUI style. I don't know why, what's wrong with it. And then you just have your OnePlus Switch, phone, recorder, and then let's just hop on to the settings. Nothing new in those apps. So again, over here, pretty much everything is working from the hotspot to the Wi-Fi. And just trust me on this, the Wi-Fi reception in this ROM is just mind-blowing. This phone almost has double the signal of my Galaxy Note 9, which is just mind-blowing for the price of it. What quality of parts Xiaomi has installed in this device, like it's complete of a flagship. Then again, you have cast, Bluetooth, everything working. If you go to the display, you have night mode, skin calibration, reading mode. Night mode and reading mode completely work over here, as you can see. As this is a Snapdragon 845 port direct, pretty much everything just works. You have screen calibration. The screen calibration is just completely broken. Custom color does work if you want to have it easier on your eyes. Pretty great. Then again, you have notch display over here. Notch is completely fixed. So as you can see, there are no left millimeters above or below than that. It's just completely perfect. Again, thanks to all the devs. And again, thanks to many of you guys, my subscribers, who actually helped me in making this video as stable as possible for others. Again, hats off to you guys. Again, scrolling down here, apps in full screen. So if you have any kind of notch issue in PUBG and stuff, again, just come over here, put it onto the full screen. Everything is okay. Then you have ambient display. Ambient display does really work, but on LCD, who even uses it? Like, why? You have 4 clock styles to go through. Pretty great, not going to lie. Then we have wallpapers, theme. In theme, you can actually switch between light. As you can see, UI goes completely light, just like Android Pie. Pretty great, those who use it, but you also have a dark option. As you can see, even though this is LCD, again, the panel that Xiaomi has installed is pretty amazing. If you leave the screen bleeding behind, the panel goes really, really dark. As you can see, it almost looks like an AMOLED. But in the themes, you can also choose your accent colors. If you want any kind of color, you can just tap over here and you can choose between anything. You can also input hex data for it, which is just amazing. I can just switch it to green, like cyan one, pretty great. But let's just switch to the colorful, which I like, the stock one. Again, the status bar has been completely adjusted for our fat ass notch over there, which is again an extremely great job by our developers. Then again, if you go to the sound, pretty much everything is working except OnePlus audio tuner. So again, where it is? Okay, audio tuner. This is actually broken. As you can see, it doesn't even load. So again, you can use any kind of Dolby Atmos or anything that you like in this ROM. No issues at all. If you go to the buttons and gestures, you have alert slider, which is of no use to us because we don't have a dedicated button. So if you want to choose between mute, vibrate or sound, you can always use a third party application like any kind of widget and it surely works. Then you have navigation and gestures. Now the three options you have over here is back, home and recent, which is the stock Android like navbar. Then you have back and home, again in which animations just work great. For example, it will pop up once and then it's just hella smooth, like look at it. Again, you have navigation gestures from OnePlus, which are one of the best ones. Like it's so like butter smooth, I can't even express. But let's just go back, we have more options over here. You also have quick gestures. Again, the quick gestures don't actually work over here as our new display driver in the Pi Beta, which has all the touch issues fixed, only supports double tap to wake. So yeah, double tap to wake does actually work, but the screen of gestures are completely broken. So if you use a global stable ROM, that might work. If you go to the battery, you have battery optimization, adaptive battery from the Android Pi, which is again great. Not like Samsung, they have actually bogged down these features, but in OxygenOS, you pretty much get everything. So again, going to the storage, nothing much. So let's just go to the security. Now in the security, you have pretty much 1 month ago security patch, December 1, which is great. Then again, going to the actual biometrics, fingerprint scanner works and face unlock sort of works. So in this video, it actually works with IR scanner and Google Trusted Face. So it's pretty secure and not secure at the same time. But in the next video, surely I will make an updated video on this in which official face unlock of OxygenOS will be working, like devs are really working on it. In my previous video, I said it's pretty much impossible, but on Snapdragon 845, there are chances. So face unlock does actually work in this ROM. There you go, pretty fast. You can actually enroll it with your IR scanner, which is again amazing that it works on a custom ROM. Like you could never expect it to work on a Samsung phone. Then again, scroll down, you have accounts, nothing much. If you go to the utilities, you have gaming mode, which again helps in bunch of the stuff. Such as for example, if you enable network boost, you will get much more better ping in PUBG. Just trust me. Again, you have pretty useful options over here. Scrolling down, you have digital well-being enabled in this ROM. So again, OxygenOS does have this, but not embedded into the setting. So you even get it, which is again amazing. You can keep a track of your battery drain. Again, pretty handy stuff. But if you go to down Google system, nothing much about phone. As you can see, it's running a OnePlus 6 port. This is not a 5T or 5 base. So you get the latest of OxygenOS running on OnePlus 6 on your Pocophone F1, which is just amazing how stable it is. If you go to the Android version, Android 9, Pi, and then let's just talk about the bugs of it. Now the only bugs over here are the camera. Now the camera works, I mean pretty much you can click pictures, you can record video, but the extra features that come with it, such as the pro mode, night mode and stuff, are just completely broken over here. And for some odd weird reason, if you install the ANX camera, which is the MIUI camera port for your Pocophone F1, it just completely breaks down the camera module. It just doesn't work at all. So the only workaround over here is you can install a Google camera, which again works just amazing. The HDR in this thing is out of the world. Again, the notch is fixed in this camera. Also, it comes with night sight and stuff, which is again completely working. You have manual focus over here. Also, the manual ISO completely working. And talking about the quick toggle, such as for example, torch, it is also broken, even though the camera module is working. But in order to fix the torch, you can always use an app called Godly Torch. Just go to it and select my device for Mi 6, the Sagitt, and it just works perfect. For example, you can adjust the yellow LED, the master control for it, and it just works perfect. As you can see, wow, the torch is really bright for this thing. just turn it off and it just works perfect. So again, that's the workaround for it. And if you want to now fix the sound mode, which is controlled by the alert slider, you can always use a widget like something like this, such as for example vibrate, sound, mute, completely works over there. And yeah guys, that's pretty much it for the complete review of Oxygen OS on our Pocophone F1. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you want a complete installation video of this thing, it will be coming up tomorrow. Yes, I am not delaying it. Almost everything works in this thing. And if you have more questions about this, please join my streaming channel. You can ask me anything whenever I stream, and see you guys in the next one. Peace.